Okay, good job, mate. Really, really well done. That was a fantastic drive. Bring it home.
Qualifying finished, it's time to remind ourselves once again of our top three. The owner driver, Verstappen and Lewis Hamilton. Well, that wraps up qualifying, but don't worry, we'll be back tomorrow as we head into the Grand Prix. Welcome to one of this year's most challenging races, where the combination of high speed and complex corners makes this one of the drivers' favorite tracks. It's time for the Japanese Grand Prix. We're southwest of the city of Nagoya today at the unique figure of eight Suzuka Circuit. 3.6 miles and 18 corners make up a lap here, with average speeds approaching 136 miles per hour. DRS will be available, of course, into the potential passing opportunity at turn one, although the best place for overtaking will be through 130R and into the final chicane. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. It's the owner driver then in pole position, and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Hamilton, Fernando Alonso, Norris, Gasly, Russell, Leclerc, Albon, Tsunoda, Perez, Joe, Ricciardo, Bottas, Sainz, Magnussen, Ocon, Hülkenberg, Oscar Piastri, Armstrong, Stroll, and Logan Sargeant. Now it's almost time for lights out, so let's go down to the track. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into turn one, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It will keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix. We'll be right back.
8 DRS is now available. See, your teammate behind is 11.4 seconds. Behind by 2.6 seconds. Okay, gap to the car behind. Car behind, 1.9 seconds. tyre concerns at the moment, just focus on the driving. Car behind trailing us, 2.1 seconds. We're approaching the pit window and you're going to be on mediums. this lap, in this lap. Push now.
It looks like the pit crew are out in the lane and ready to perform their magic on the car. They're going to be aiming to achieve the fastest pit stop time possible.
Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. So Marcus is in the pits. Marcus in the pits. Okay, push, push. Gap to the car behind. 4.0 seconds. That's a new fastest lap of the race. OK, so we're leading our teammate by 23.4 seconds. We'll be right back. gap to your teammate behind is 28.7 seconds. No issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 33.0 seconds. Okay, that's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining, 5 laps of fuel left. We'll be right back. enough fuel for three more laps. Oh, superb driving. That is the race win, my friend. Well done.
It wasn't always plain sailing today, but it was a very important win nonetheless. Anthony Davidson. Help them deliver this result, do you think?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Well, what a thrilling end to an incredible Grand Prix weekend. Our top three finishers should be incredibly happy with what they were able to achieve out there today. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant? Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.